one of my leader. He's still, thank God, he's still alive. His name is Shabbir Ahmad Shah. Shabbir Ahmad Shah, he has been in prison for 26 years. 26 years. But what my, as my counsel said, that even the judge did not deny that we have a just cause. But obviously there were mistakes which were committed, and because of that I have to pay for that. But one thing I would like to tell you, even after my arrest, which was in July of last year, 2 months back there was a very important discussion at the State Department, at the State Department of the United States. And it was a question by one of the Indian journalists there, why do you have dot between India and Pakistan and Kashmir on the map? And the spokesperson lady, she said, because Kashmir is a disputed territory. And another question was, but if you are saying that Kashmir is a disputed territory, India is going to be very angry. My dear friend, the answer was, but that is our policy. So that's why, my dear friend, whether I am inside or outside. And secondly, it's not really me who was really doing, although my counsel said that he did this and he did that. It was a collective effort of thousands of people, and you are seeing the hundreds of them who are here. So whatever little we achieved in Washington and elsewhere, it was the people from Kashmir, from both sides of the ceasefire line, whether they were from India or from Pakistan. And they are out, and you can see they have zeal, they have determination, and more importantly, we have the support of the United States of America. And that support has been there right from day one, from Harry Truman. And I will tell you really one important development. That was on February 22nd of 2006. President George Bush, while giving a speech, he made a mistake. He said that we will accept that solution of Kashmir, which is acceptable to India and Pakistan. And he did not say a word about Kashmir. Then 2 hours later, he called the Indian press to the White House. And he said, George W. Bush, as the President of the United States. And he said, let me clarify what I said at the Asia Society. We will accept that solution of Kashmir, which is acceptable to India, Pakistan, and the people of Kashmir. So that's why we have the support of the United States. We have the support of the United Nations. And the people on the ground, they are really fully for the Azadi. Azadi means independence. So they are fully ready for the freedom. And in millions they are coming on the streets, and more importantly, it is non-violent, it is more peaceful. So because of that, tomorrow is going to be a really beautiful tomorrow.
So, your position is independence, an independent Kashmir, not a Kashmir by Pakistan.
There was a survey that was conducted by a British think tank. It is a very prestigious think tank, it is known as Chatham House. They conveyed us, they did a survey in Kashmir. It was on May 27, 2010. And according to that survey, my dear friend, I met the director of that institution in London. According to that survey, 90 to 95%, can you believe it? 90 to 95% from the Valley of Kashmir. I come from the Valley of Kashmir. Kashmir is fire region, but I come from the Valley of Kashmir. 90 to 95% of the people of the Valley of Kashmir, they want Azadi. They want independence. So that's why, but my position is, whether Kashmir becomes part of India, why not? Because India has a legitimate right to convince the Kashmiri people to become the part of India. So my point position is, whether Kashmir becomes part of India, or the part of Pakistan, or becomes independent, it must not, it cannot be decided by India and Pakistan alone. It has to be decided by the people of Kashmir, irrespective of their religious background. Whether they are Muslims, they are Hindus, they are Sikhs, they are Buddhists. My counsel does not know. She has a lot of letters which came from Kashmir. I found it yesterday. There are more than 10 letters which are written by Kashmiri Hindus in support of me. Why? Because they know that Kashmir is not a communal. They know that Kashmir issue is not a communal issue. They know Kashmir issue is not a fundamentalist issue. They know that Kashmir is not a struggle between Hindus and Muslims. They know that Kashmir is not a fight between secularism and theocracy. They know, these Kashmiri Hindus, that Kashmir is the struggle of life of self-determination. I think with that, it is almost...